what you should have after you unbox is your tablet, your pen, and your USB cable. You'll also have a driver CD, but I recommend that you download the newest drivers from Wacom's website. So the way that you find those drivers is do a Google search for Intuos drivers, and it should be one of the first links that comes up, drivers for Wacom, from Wacom's website. You click on that link, you'll get to this drivers page, and if you scroll down, you will see some different drivers. You want to look for latest driver for Intuos, and you'll download either the Windows or the Mac version. I'm on a Windows computer, so I downloaded the Windows version. It'll take a minute to download, and then once it's downloaded, go to your downloads folder or wherever you downloaded the file to, and double click to install the drivers. Now it'll take a minute to install the drivers, and then it'll want to restart your computer. Go ahead and restart, and then after it's restarted, continue with this. We will ensure that our tablet is working properly after the drivers are installed. So I'm going to plug in the USB cable here in the back. You want to make sure that it's going the right way. And there you go, it's plugged in at the top. The express keys go up. Then I'm going to plug this other end into the USB port on my computer. Doesn't really matter which one. And since the drivers are installed, it'll just take a quick second to do its thing with the computer here and recognize the tablet. And momentarily we should have a functioning tablet. You'll see that this white LED light came on, and what that's showing is that the tablet is powered on, that it's receiving power from your computer. And now it says Wacom tablet device software installed successfully. So if we move our finger on the tablet now, you can see that it's working. It works as a trackpad would on your laptop if you have a laptop. You can also see that this blue light lights up anytime I touch the pad or if I hover with my pen over the pad. And our pen works by hovering slightly over your tablet, but don't actually touch the tip to the tablet itself. Just hover. And when you want to do a mouse click, let's say minimize this window, you tap with your pen. You can also tap and hold, and you can move windows around. You can double tap to do a double click. You can use the top button on your pen here to do a right click, and we can configure this in different ways. So what might be a little confusing about this tablet to begin with is when you're using the trackpad here, it doesn't matter where you really put your finger down on your tablet, you're going to move your mouse. Let's say if I put my finger here and I move my mouse down, it's just going to move my mouse down or up. My pen works differently. The pen works in relation to where you are on your tablet. So if my pen is pointed here in the top corner of the tablet, you can see that the cursor moves to the top corner. If I put my pen down here in the bottom left corner, you can see the pen moves down there. So the pen points to the different part of the screen in relation to where it is on the canvas. The trackpad, however, just moves the mouse from wherever it's at. So that might be a little confusing to begin with, but you'll get used to that.